behalf of Sports Nasha, today we are interviewing Dr. Yuvraj, who is a sports physiotherapist practicing in Vilayapalle and also head of sports physiotherapy in MGM Medical College, New Mumbai. Also, he is India coordinator for World Spine Care, which is WHO approved organization. So, welcome Dr. Yuvraj. And today we are going to speak about injuries to the players. We have heard about tennis elbow, we have heard about a knee injury, we have heard about back injury, but first time something serious we are hearing about neck injury. So can you explain us or our viewers, what is this neck injury?
Neck injuries could be of two types in sports. One could be traumatic injury which happens during the game, or it could be a traumatic injury which is because of overuse or because of muscle weakness or something like that. That is two injuries. Traumatic injuries are more seen in contact sports. It could be as serious as a paraplegia, that means the sports person at the end of that is not able to move the legs. That's the thing. Now the another aspect of this is the traumatic injuries, which are because generally because of overuse of the body that way. And this will be, if you ask me, this will be more related to the disc. The disc is a structure which lies between the two. So in cervical spine, I would say there are 7 vertebras, and there are between each vertebra there are discs.
Yeah.
And lying cushion. Yeah, it's like just like a cushion. And lying just behind the disc are your nerves, which are supplying your hand and everything. So if the disc is pushing, coming out of its alignment and touching any of these nerves, you can get pain. That could be one way of injuring this. Or he just does a lot of training, has a very increased workload. He's just playing day in, day out, he's playing. And that generally is the main cause of disc injuries in players.
India's current captain Virat Kohli, he is suffering from the neck injury. As per the reports from the press, it has been heard that he is suffering from a severe neck injury. Now, as we all know, Virat Kohli has been doing lot of hard work on the field, continuously playing. So, whether his injury is due to wear and tear, exactly what could be his injury? We are just guessing. But
we are guessing. So again, we are guessing. So what even the reports which we have seen in the media, which suggest that Virat Kohli is suffering from some disc bulges, and I think one of the orthopedic had commented in Times of India that he is having the MRI report shows he has some disc bulges, and so we don't know what is the clinical picture. Okay, so there is also one thing which is very important to understand is that finding disc bulges on an MRI in a person who is 27, 28, 29 is a common phenomenon.
With so much of exposure.
One should not be surprised if the MRI of a player who is as workaholic like Virat Kohli will have some disc bulges. So that should not really bother us. Now clinically, if it's just a neck injury, the prognosis or the future is bright. Okay, it should, with good medications, good rehabilitation, I am very sure he should be back to full fitness.
Okay.
So that's not a thing.
How many days?
3 months.
3 months?
3 months, yeah.
3 months.
3 months. 3 months would be an average time, I would say.
To become fully fit.
Fully fit, yeah. The pain should go away. To be fully fit and back to sports, back to full fitness, I would say would be a period of around 3 months.
That could create a doubt for his England tour.
That could create a doubt for his England tour.
Absolutely. Yeah. Doctor, you have said, said it, and let us be open to discussion.
If it is something little bit more serious like a disc injury, which is not compressing on any nerve. Again, now there are two types of disc injury. If there is a disc injury not compressing on any nerve, this should take, as I just said, around 3 months. The reason is that compared to a muscle, a disc takes more time to heal.
Okay.
Okay, so muscle, because it has more blood supply, heal faster.
Okay.
Test, which has a very poor blood supply, will heal slower.
That's very muscle nice. Very nice.
Takes weeks, and a disc will take months. Okay. Third category. Now let's, fingers crossed, this should not happen, but let's say the disc is pushing behind and touching a nerve. If it's pushing behind and touching the nerve, so it will be a disc injury with nerve involvement. That is pretty more serious.
Okay.
Yeah. So that might not get better by mere medicines and rehabilitation, and might need a surgical intervention.
Yeah.
Surgical. Yeah. Might need. Okay.
Might need.
Right. So that is a more serious, which you can now take more time to recover than just even 3 months.
Doctor, these days there is a craze in youngsters about fitness. Now also, of course, those celebrities, they have proper guidance and proper trainers and professional trainers. Still, they have injuries.
Yes.
Now, what is your advice to these youngsters who are just following blindly?
Yeah, so very true, because even in the clinic, we get a lot of patients who go to a gym and then end up with a neck pain or a back pain and who visit us. And the cause for this generally is a bad form or bad technique of doing an exercise. Exercise by themselves are not harmful, but you need to have a good instructor with you when you are doing this. So that is one thing. You have to learn the exercise. That is the thing. Okay, so pain is a very unique thing. Okay, in some people, if I have injury, both have same injury, I can say I am in severe pain, you can say you are not in pain. So pain is a very subjective kind of
subjective. Okay.
So what can influence, if you ask me, would be the psychological status of this. So if somebody is stressed or anxious or depressed, that can really aggravate the pain. So that is very important. Okay, so that is
very good point.
So stress can definitely aggravate this.
If he continues in that state for a few more minutes also, as a doctor you may be knowing what are the serious
results. Okay, so for this, in medical, we have identified what we call it the red flags. If those things are there, there is no debate on should a player continue or not. He should not continue. So let's say a player has a pain along with some weakness in his hand or something like that. It clearly indicates he should be not
back.
It should be the World Cup final, it will be the last, so he can't play, because that could be
lifelong.
It could be very serious. Things such as severe pain, which is not getting relieved by rest or medications or physiotherapy, also for me would be a kind of a red flag. So that is the thing. If there are no red flags, it is just a muscle injury, most of these players then choose to continue taking some pain medications or some injections or something,
spray
or something, and they still do well.
Right.
And then the healing part of that will happen once the match is done.
Doctor, we would like to discuss with you on more subjects.
Sure.
There are more subjects to be discussed on the injuries in sports.
Yeah. Sure.
There will be many more injuries in the England tour.
Sure. Let's hope.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you.
Thanks.